Hello everyone, this is Eddie the Magic Monk. What I'm going to do now is show you how to build a quick 5-minute robot with the Lego Mindstorms EV3 kit so that you can get a robot up and running pretty quickly. And basically all this robot will do is be able to drive around sort of like a car. So let's get your brick. And you can see here on the side of the brick, we have a few holes on the side of the brick. Now these holes can be filled with pegs. Now pegs are just things that you can insert into the holes in order to connect beams together. Right, so beams, oops, this is in the wrong spot. So beams are either straight or they can be angular beams, right? And they can be connected to the brick through these pegs. So I'm going to firstly use one of these little beams, a yellow beam, and I'm going to put a blue peg through it, one of these longer pegs, right? I'm going to put it through the yellow, beam, and then actually I'm gonna put two of them through the yellow beam, and then I'm gonna put this through this brick, right, vertically on the right hand side, and make sure you press the pegs in. And I'm gonna do it on the left hand side as well. Might as well do it now to get it out of the way. So put get two of these pegs, put it through the beams, put it through the yellow beam, and then peg it on the left hand side of the brick vertically downwards. Alright, so the robot now looks like this. Okay, so the next thing we're going to do is get an angular beam, and it's gonna be one of these ones with 5 holes vertical, 3 holes horizontal, and we're going to put it, attach it to the yellow beam like this, so that we have one hole sticking on top of it. All right, so it's like this, and then we're going to do it on the other side as well. So same beam on the other side with one hole sticking on top, so it looks like this. All right, so pretty easy so far. So as you can see with the blue peg, it is pretty useful to use the blue peg when you want to join 3 things together. So we have 3 parts joined together: the brick, the yellow beam, and the white angular beam. All right, so pegs are just used to join beams up. And now what we're going to do is we're going to connect a motor to these 3 holes on the side of the brick. All right, so let's get a motor from the box. All right, grab a motor, and then what we're going to do is we're going to get 3 black pegs, 3 black pegs, and we're going to hook it up, right, to the first and the last hole on the side of the brick. Right, and then we're going to join up the motor, the large motor, to these 2 pegs and just push it in. All right, so it's now hooked up. All right, and let's do the same on this side. So put 2 of these pegs onto the first and the last hole horizontally on the angular beam, and then get a motor and push it in. Okay, so you can see here I have a robot with two motors on the sides. Now you might feel that these motors are a little bit loose, right? A little bit loose. It'll probably still work, a little bit loose. So I'm gonna connect them down below. So flip it over, and then you'll see some holes on the back of the motors, right? So now I'm gonna grab one of these longer beams, longer straight beams, and I'm gonna put a peg at the end, on the ends of the beam. So on the left hand side, put a peg through it. Right hand side, put a peg through it. Alright, and then I'm going to put it, slot it on the bottom of the robot behind the motors. So slot it in here and here and just slot them in. It's sort of hard because the camera's in the way. Alright, so it sort of helps me stabilize it a bit more. So this is less likely to move now. Okay, so we want to now attach some wheels onto the robot. Right, so for the front wheels, you just grab them out of the black box. Front wheels are basically, you had to put the tires on the wheel yourself, so make sure you do that. So it originally came separately, put the tire on, and then you'll see through the middle of the wheel is a hole. And you actually put what we call an axle through it. An axle is basically a stick, a very long stick, right? But the shape of it is in a form of a cross, sort of. Right? So get one of the gray ones that are about 5 centimeters in length. Push it through. Push it through the wheel, and then what we call a bushing, which are these gray thingies, right? And put it one on each side of the wheel. Put one on each side of the wheel to stabilize it a little bit. Stabilize it, right? And then you're going to stick this wheel onto the, actually make it a bit longer on one side, a little bit longer on one side. And then you're gonna stick this wheel to the outside of your robot through the middle of the motor. Okay, just push it in. All right, so now the wheel is attached to the motor. Right, and push the axle in. Okay, so it goes like that. Now you're gonna do the same for that side. So grab the wheel, push the axle through it. Push the axle through it. Stabilize it with the bushing. And then stick it on the outside of your motor. So stick it through. Push the axle in a bit more. Okay, so now you have a robot like this, and if you put it on the table, okay, if you just put it on the table, you'll feel that something is missing. right? Because it's going to move like that, but your brick is going to be touching the floor. So in order to fix that, what you're going to do is you're going to use this piece here, which is actually a wheel, right? It's a metal ball that you can slot into this piece. I'm not sure what it's called, but it basically rolls around the floor like a wheel. All right. So now we're going to insert this. Insert two pegs into it. All right. Put two pegs through it. And then we're going to insert this on the back of the robot. Alright, just in front, either in front or behind, doesn't really matter. Actually, maybe do it behind then. Behind this really long beam and just slot it in. Alright, slot it in so you have a wheel on the back. And now you can drive this around. So we'll show you how to drive it around in a second, but now it can move around on the table pretty easily. Okay, thanks for watching, guys. See you next time.